Hello, welcome back to Learn Agronomy. In this video, we are going to look into the big push theory. To start with, we can understand that this theory was formulated by Paul and Rosenstein, Rodin. It was in 1943 that he has put forward this theory. According to this theory, we could see that a big push, this is considered to be a large comprehensive program which is helping to have a high minimum amount of investment in order to overcome the obstacles to development in a developing economy. Okay, so this is very much important for a developing economy to launch its path of growth. Rodin, he has believed that small efforts is not helping the developing economy to have a sustainable growth path, or in order to not sustainable growth path, it is possible to have a small kind of growth, or it is possible to have a minute growth with small minimum investment. But in order to sustain this growth path, it is very much important for an economy to go for a big push. Okay, so this process of development, if big push kind of investment is initiated, that is something that would be helping the economy to have a sustained growth path. Rodin, he has put forward four kinds of indivisibilities in his theory of big push. He has put forward indivisibility in the production function, indivisibility in demand, indivisibility in supply of savings, and psychological indivisibilities. Let's understand each of these in detail. First of all, indivisibility in production function. We know that production function, it shows a functional relationship between input and output. Okay, so inputs are very much important for a production function to have its existence. Inputs are considered to be the factors which will help in production, right? So these would include labor, raw materials, capital, etc., etc., etc. So this factors of production, this would be helping to have increasing returns to scale. The most important function with respect to production is that that creating output. So this creation of output is considered to be the end result in production. In the case of indivisibilities, we could see that the basic characteristics of certain raw materials or certain inputs are to be assumed here. We have to understand that in the case of an overhead capital, especially like power, transport, communication, these are irreversible in time. That means that investment in social overhead capital must precede investment in directly productive activities. It has got some minimum durability, and also the gestation period of this is very long. Okay, so we can understand that these indivisibilities with respect to social overhead capital are considered to be the major obstacle with respect to economic development, and this is considered to be the important obstacle in a developing economy with respect to growth. So what we have to do is that we should be able to overcome this obstacle. Coming to the indivisibility of demand capital, we know that a small size of market is something that would be helping to generate uncertainties. We know that market is something which is full of uncertainty. We cannot predict anything. We have to match the demand with supply. We will be having an equilibrium price and equilibrium quantity. And we would be able to see a large number of industries, these industries in a particular sector would be working complementary to each other. These would be working simultaneously, and this would create demand for each other's products, right? And we could see that indivisibility of demand, this is something that requires a simultaneous large investment in number of industries. One industry's output would be used as inputs for other industries, right? So in this context, it is very much important to have in order to overcome the problem of indivisibility of demand capital as well. Now, moving on to the third indivisibility, that is indivisibility in supply of saving. That means that we should have a large quantum of investment, which is very much required for an underdeveloped economy to revive its growth path. or in order to sustain this growth path. Small increase in income and additional increase in investment, it is something that is not that required. It is required if it could be sustained for long. So in order to sustain this for long, we have to have a large or a big investment rather than a small amount of investment. So a large lump sum investment is very much important in underdeveloped economies. Next, we are moving on to the fourth and final indivisibility, that is psychological indivisibilities. As per Roden, isolated and small efforts might not add up to a sufficient impact on growth. So indivisibilities make it imperative large sum of investment, and we have to, in order to reap benefits of external economies, we have to have a lump sum capital invested in the economy so as to overcome psychological indivisibilities as well. So the rationale of this particular topic of big push is that bit by bit investment is considered to be a wastage. It is a wastage of resources as per Roden, and what he prefers is a big amount of investment. He says that small investment is something which is not able to break the vicious circle. Underdeveloped economies are trapped in the vicious circle of poverty. So in order to help these economies to come out of the vicious circle of poverty, what we need is a big push. So we should have some massive amount of investment, huge initial investment, and also we should have balanced growth. Balanced growth in the sense that we should make in a simultaneous investment in a huge investment should be made simultaneously in different sectors. This is something which will be helping in planned industrialization, which will help to revive the economy, which would help the underdeveloped economy to come out of this problem of vicious circle of poverty, and this would help underdeveloped economy to choose a path of growth, and this would further help the economy to sustain its growth path. This big push theory, it is not free from criticisms. We could see that Min has argued that this theory stresses the need for big efforts. And in the case of underdeveloped economies, especially when these are facing some problems with availability of dynamic entrepreneurs, skilled labor, etc., when we argue for this big push kind of approach, is this something that is unattainable? Ellis has pointed out that this theory ignores the shortage of saving and risk involved in investment. We know that in order to have huge investment, huge saving itself is needed, and in the case of underdeveloped economy, especially when people have low income, it is very much difficult for them even to think about big savings. The possibility of external diseconomies is something that is not visualized in the theories. When we are talking about external economies, we have to consider the other side as well. The other side is external diseconomy. So when we are looking onto lumpiness of investment in different industries, we have to think about external diseconomies as well. Mint again pointed out the difficulty with respect to coordinate various complex development plans, especially when we are making planning under the banner of big push. At the times of problems, we might be facing difficulties with respect to coordination, and each of the industries would be competing, right? So each of the industry would be competing in the sense that each industry would be having a profit motive in its mind. So every industry would be performing in such a way as to attain maximum profit from the market. So in this case, it is very much difficult for an underdeveloped economy to go for a big push. And Winner has pointed out the role of indivisibilities, which would be preventing the economy from attaining growth path. And in many cases, we could see that governments are likely to face difficulties with respect to implementation of development plans, and execution is something which is very much difficult for an underdeveloped economy. Adler, he has criticized this theory on the ground that it ignores the importance of small investment. When the theory says that bit by bit investment is a wastage of resources, especially in an underdeveloped economy, it is something which is unthinkable to go for a huge lump sum investment, the only possible way here is to have bit by bit amount or a small by a small investment in one or two sectors. Simultaneous investment, that too lump sum investment in each of the sectors, is something that is unimaginable for an underdeveloped economy. So that's all for today. Please like, share and subscribe this to this channel for more videos, and you can be a part of my Telegram group and Telegram channel to discuss your doubts. I'll be providing the links of the same in the description box. That's all for today. Thank you.